Colliers lays out some recommendations on improving the Philippines' property sector after the economy logged a slightly slower pace of expansion than expected. The real estate consultant said the pre-selling condominium market in Metro Manila continues to see tepid launches and take-up due to elevated mortgage rates and lengthened remaining inventory life. That's why Colliers Research Director Joey Bondoc says property stakeholders need to challenge the status quo because simply building office or residential towers is not enough. He explains developers need to be more strategic with their land banking and development initiatives to stand out. As for office spaces, Colliers says net take-up in Metro Manila during the first quarter of 2024 tripled compared to the same period in 2023. With stable demand from traditional and outsourcing companies. The firm also sees growth in office hubs outside the metro.
RCBC nets 2.2 billion pesos in quarterly net income. This was down from the 3.6 billion last year. The bank, however, notes growth in its core businesses pushed revenues to 11.6 billion pesos, with net interest income also higher by 32%. As for Axelum Resources, it swung back to profitability in Q1. The Mani Pangilinan-backed coconut exporter reversed last year's losses to report a 106 million peso profit. Generated sales climbed to 1.6 billion pesos on double-digit volume growth in its core product segments. ICTSI expanding its footprint in southern Luzon. The port's giant is building a new international container terminal in the town of Bawan in Batangas Province. The price tag, a staggering $800 million or 46 billion pesos. ICTSI says the new terminal will be the largest privately funded marine terminal investment in the Philippines. The Bawan facility will boast of a 20-foot equivalent unit capacity of over 2 million. Construction begins next year, with target completion in 2027. Meanwhile, Bell Corporation formally applies for the voluntary delisting of its unit, Premium Leisure Corp. It submitted today the petition to the stock exchange to take PLC private by July 9. Shareholders of the C family's gaming arm approved last month the plan to delist by a tender offer of 85 centavos per share. Next, to the property for share swap between Megaworld and its real estate investment trust. Megaworld is subscribing to 926 million common shares of Emreid, priced at over 13 billion pesos. In exchange, Emreid gets six of Megaworld's Grade A buildings in Taguig, Iloilo, and in Davao. This would raise Emreid's total portfolio to 482,000 square meters. And finally, Cavitex Infrastructure taps EI Corporation as the builder of its segment for extension. The undertaking by the Metro Pacific Tollways Unit will seek to link Cavitex to the Cavite Laguna Expressway, or CALAX. Contract price was set at 1.8 billion pesos.
The Philippine Stock Exchange welcomed today its first initial public offering of the year. Oceana Gold Philippines rang the ceremonial bell this morning at the former trading floor of the PSE in Makati. Now, OGP is the first mining company to list at the local bourse in over a decade. The Philippine subsidiary of the company based in Canada and Australia, also known operator of the Didipio mine in Nueva Vizcaya province. Its debut price, though, was flat, and the mining producer traded in the red, down by 4%. Average price to the 12 pesos and 85 centavos from its offer of 13 pesos and 33 centavos apiece.